Hey guys, welcome back to Caveman Mining. I hope everyone is well and having a great day. On today's video, we are going to be breaking down the test bench, taking off the AMD 6600 non-XT and getting it up onto our hanging rig that is in HiveOS. And like we did before with the hash rate testing on the 6600, we're gonna do a little bit more of that, but in Hive on the hanging rig, seeing what we get for hash rates and efficiency, we'll check out what we have at the wall. All right, guys, we got her hanging up on the rig, and I really wanted to get her on the top shelf there, but there is not enough clearance, just slightly over the size limit to fit in between the top rails. I could have just the middle and take everything down, but I'm not gonna do that. Instead, I just shifted things over a little bit. We got it hanging on the bottom shelf. I kind of tiered the other cards to fit. Cable management, total disaster. I will fix that at a later date. I just wanted to get this thing powered up, connected onto Hive, and we'll go into Hive in just a second to see that it is now hashing and working, and we'll check to see what the hash rates are. All right, guys, so we are now in HiveOS, and as you can see, the RX 6600 is hashing away in the software at the display. It's reporting 28.88, temperature 40 degrees Celsius, 43 watts, and we'll take a look at these overclocks a little bit more intimately here. So 900 on the core clock, 620 on the core voltage, 625 on the memory controller voltage, 950 on the memory clock, and 1100 on the memory voltage. So that is the numbers that I could come up with to kind of get this sweet spot between bouncing between 2892 and 2886 seems to be the numbers of where we're bouncing back and forth. Let me go ahead and kick up a Hive shell start, a fresh session, so we can see what it looks like in the miner itself versus at the HiveOS display, just to give us a little bit more, you know, accuracy or you know, granularity in terms of the hash rate and the power. And let's do a refresh and let's get into the miner, check what we have here. So yep, 28.89, and let's see what the next reported hash rate is here while it grabs all the jobs. 28.86, like I said, kind of bouncing around slightly there. Power level 43 watts, which is pretty darn good. We'll wait for one more hash rate to see if we can get something a little bit higher than this 28.86. And yeah, our fan looks like it's about 55% on the cooling percentage there, so we could obviously experiment and try to crank that up, but I think we're okay for now. 28.88, so like I said, still kind of bouncing back and forth. Let's take a walk over to the wall. Just before we do that, a reminder, on this hanging rig there is two PSUs behind there, so we're gonna get a little bit of a off reading in terms of the wattage for power, just because there's two PSUs, not really efficient, versus like on our test bench, we have one, which you saw we did in Windows. So let's see what that is. Anyways, we said 43 in the software of watts, and taking a look at our Space Goats meter, we are at between 153 watts, and we just got like a spike up to like 161 I saw there. So yeah, between 150, I'd say between 153 and 161 seems to be the wattage there at the wall. If we were to just use one power supply, I assume that would be a lot less wattage at the wall there, but it is what it is in terms of our test with HiveOS. But yeah, let's go ahead and take a look at RavenCoin in just a second. All right, before we jump over to RavenCoin, we're just a little bit impatient. So we could see the hash rate is 28.92 there and 28.91, so we're able to achieve up the higher rate of the hash rate on Ethereum. So now we will switch over to Raven. We'll see you there. All right, so we have switched the flight sheets over to RavenCoin, and adjusted some clocks here. So we've got on the core clock 1300, 665 on the core voltage, 690 on the MEM control voltage, 950 again on the MEM clock, 1100 on the MEM voltage, and we set the fan to 90% just to get a little bit more cooling power there. So let's take a look at shell in a box, and we've got some hash rates ranging from pretty steady, but ranging from 14.74 to 14.73, and the wattage here is consistent with 50 watts of power. And yeah, the card is staying fairly cool at that speed, so it's saying 39 degrees Celsius, so you know, probably don't need that much power in terms of the fan. Let's see if we could kind of trim it down a little bit and save, maybe see if we can save a little wattage. Obviously that gets, sounds a little bit quieter on the the ears, but let's see if that affects hash rate by any means here. So 14.74, 50 watts, let's see what we get for the next upcoming hash rate here, and then we'll take a walk over to the wall. Yeah, so we did did get kind of affected there a little bit by the dropping the fan down. So 14.69. Let's go ahead and experiment by cranking it up to 100%, not 1000%, and see if that makes a huge difference. If we can get over the 14.74, that would be cool. And we can hear the card spooling up there. 14.69, 50 watts. Just gonna wait for this next coming hash rate. Let's take another look at it in the software. Yeah, everything matching up there. Taking a look here at Hive Shell. Yeah, and this card, it's pretty efficient so far on Ravencoin. I must say, 14, you know, high 14s, almost 15s. That's pretty good at 50 watts in the software. Let's take a walk over to the wall as we get that last hash rate to come up there. See how bad we are affected at the wall versus like Ethereum. And I think at Ethereum we were like between 153 and 163. So yeah, quite a little bit higher on the Ravencoin, bouncing between 170 and one. I just saw a spike up to 190, which is pretty high, but looks like between 170, 171 and like 180 seems to be the bouncing back between all of those wattages there. And we'll take one more look at the hash rate here. And yeah, 14.73. So yeah, staying pretty steady at that high 14 mark, but not too bad on Raven. We'll do one more test on Ergo and then we will give our concluding thoughts. All right, last but not least, we have Ergo going, and we're already at a hash rate of 56.53, temperature sitting at a chilly 44 Celsius and 41 watts in the software. Let's take a look at the clocks that we have. Is 900 core clock, 620 the core voltage, 620 the MEM, 950 MEM clock, and 1100 on the MEM voltage. Let's take a quick look into Hive Shell. So you can see here we've got hash rates ranging between 56.50, 56.53, 56.54, and we notice with Ergo there's always like this one time the hash like dips down low. It's very strange. You can see there on the bottom it's dipped down to 29.70, and it should spike back up on the next hash, but you could see power level in the software 42 watts, and then 41 watts rather, excuse me, at 56.55 mega hash. So let's take a look over at the wall, take a look at our final wattage here on the Space Goats power meter. And we've got a pretty steady, very, very steady compared to the other hash rates, 51 watts between 150 and 151. Saw a spike up to like 155 there, but pretty steady. Ergo seems to be the more steady of the algorithms with this card at the wall, at least. In the software, still doing pretty decent there at 56.52. So I just want to give my final thoughts on this card running in Hive OS. Clearly on Ethereum, we were able to get a little bit higher, just a smidge higher in terms of hash rates on the test bench in Windows than we were in Hive OS. But I think if we were to just have one power supply running on hanging rig unit in Hive OS, we probably would see a little bit better efficiency than at the wall than what we did with this single rig. But in terms of Raven, I was pretty stoked to see, you know, the high 14s on the hash rate. And in terms of Ergo, you know, getting 56 in terms of hash rate is pretty darn good, and getting in the mid 56s is really good as well on this card. So very power efficient. Still haven't really made my comparison on, you know, comparing is this in fact better than the XT versus the non-XT, that type of thing, and is the 6700 XT better than both of these cards. Still kind of to be determined, but I like what I see. I would still get more of these cards if I could get them pretty cheap, you know, in the $300, $400 range. I would scoop them up if they were available, just because of the long-term efficacy of the low power efficiency. So with all this said, guys, I hope you enjoyed these hash rate tests on the 6600 non-XT in Windows and in Hive OS. If you liked what you saw, please give a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. That is much appreciated, and we will see you on the next video. Take care, guys.